This video is made possible by Storyblocks Video. Hey folks, Jordy here for Cinecom.net, and stuff has been going pretty fast lately. As you can see, we've got a brand new studio, but actually it's not finished yet. We still want to put up stuff behind me on the wall. Basically, this is a second building within our studio, which we can use to store junk, which we already did, and we got this extra space right here for a new studio. I've also been working super hard on a lot of things behind the channel. The short film is also finally getting some shape, and Jill, we got a new team member, so we are now with 4 people. That's really awesome. And, you know, that and a million other things are going on behind the scenes right now. But okay, that's not why you're here. You are probably here because you want to see a sponsor segment. Okay, I'm just joking. Let's start with the tutorial. The first fast and easy effect is called Shatter and works pretty good on text. Basically, it shatters your text element just like the name says. By default, you will see a wireframe of the effect, but we're going to change that to rendered to see the final result. Under shape, you can choose in which kind of shapes your text has to shatter, for example, glass. Now, I'm not going to cover every single option within this effect, but here are a few important ones to know. The repetitions will define how small or large the shattered pieces have to be. You got 2 forces that could have an influence on the animation of the shatter, but with 1 force, you can already accomplish much. The position of the forces defines on which point your text has to shatter. The radius tells how much that has to shatter. You could, for example, only shatter a piece from your text. And finally is the strength, which is how far the pieces have to explode away from each other. Then the last important settings are the physics. From here, you can choose which direction the pieces have to go to. You can play around with the gravity controls. For example, increase the gravity inclination until the pieces fly towards you. So let's create a simple animation on the text so that it flies in. Looks good. Now set the force 1 radius to 0 and create a keyframe for it at the point that you want the shatter to start. Then go a little bit forward in time and change the value to around 0.5. And this will create a very nice shattering effect. A little bonus tip, use the effect called CC Force Motion Blur to add a natural motion blur to the animation. Alright, that was a long one, but it's really cool. The next one is definitely faster and easier. Apply the effect called Motion Tile to a clip. When you now decrease the scale of that clip, you can see better what happens. Within the effect, we can increase the output width and height, and make sure to enable mirror so that the edges are not so prominent. What you can do now is animate the scale of this clip from 100 to 50, then animate the second clip next to it from 200 to 100. Doing so gives you that typical Sam color zoom effect. Of course, you can also do it the other way around and have it zoom in. Good question, Janik. All of those great stock clips are coming from Storyblocks Video, our sponsor today.
What is that?
What, Janik? You don't know what Storyblocks is? Alright, so Storyblocks is an incredible online library packed with hundreds of thousands of stock clips, After Effects templates, backgrounds, visual effects, and so much more. And the great thing is that I can download whatever I want as much as I want. There's no limit at how much I can download, and I can use everything for commercial purposes.
That sounds very expensive.
Expensive? Janik, okay, I know that it might sound expensive, but for some reason Storyblocks is only asking a super cheap fixed price per year or per month. So Janik, make sure to check it out, and also you guys, you can do so by clicking the first link in the description below. Oh, and by the way, all of the backgrounds that you can see in the examples that we're creating are all coming from Storyblocks. Now let's turn a song, an audio song, into a visual spectrum. That's the next one. Simply create a solid and, of course, have a song in your composition as well. Look for the audio spectrum effect and drag it over to your solid. From the effects options, make sure to target your audio layer. This will already visualize its frequency spectrum and its volume. Now, interesting now is that you can create a path with the mask tool, such as a circle. Make sure that your mask is set to none instead of to add. From the audio spectrum settings, change your path to mask. Furthermore, you can tweak how the visualization should look like and, of course, add more effects to it, like a glow, etc. And this gives you that very typical animation when listening to music on YouTube. next one, search for CC light rays and apply that to your clip. Now, there are two uses to this effect. The first one is to emphasize a highlight. So right here, I've got a shot where someone lifts up a glass in front of some headlights of a car. The only thing that I do is position the center of that effect to a highlight point. Now, you might want to change the intensity, radius, and softness to your desire, but this already gives you a nice effect as the glass moves over the frame. A second use is with some text. The effect doesn't work so great on text layers, so that's why we are first going to pre-compose the text and then apply the CC light rays effect to that. This time I'm going to animate the center so that it moves over the text. Once you got that in place, we're also going to animate the intensity so that the light rays grow as it moves over the text and fades back out. There's also an effect called CC light burst, which works kind of similar but has a different look to it. So you can choose whatever works best for you. All right, and that brings us to the last one, which is the puppet tool. Basically, this tool allows you to create points in your shot. Normally, this is used for character animation, where each point is placed onto a joint. You can then move or animate each point to make your character move. However, it also works on normal shots. For instance, place a few points on your mouth, and as you laugh, you animate it so that it stretches out your face. You can do a lot of fun things with this. Or you can link one of the pinpoints to the audio volume and have you headbang automatically. I've been on the west side, cause it's where I stay. I just made 1,000, blew it in your face. I've been going in, oh, I'ma close. But that's for a different story. Thank you so much for watching. Thank you, Storyblocks, for the support. And as always, stay creative.
So Zach King is asking everyone to submit a video so that he can react to your video. So that's also what we're gonna do. We're gonna make something really cool. We had this idea of, you know, this You got it?